You see, it's big government politics as usual with too many people in Washington. Only the GOP is just slightly smaller government than the big government of Democrats. They're all progressives. I shouldn't say that. Not all of them. There are several people, I think maybe a couple, that haven't completely lost their soul in the Democratic Party. And they're maybe 20, I'm not sure anymore, that haven't lost their soul in the Republican Party. See, that's the problem with our country today. Everybody's lost their soul to progressivism. You aren't being presented with a real choice. I mean, look at the difference between these two parties. They were spending like drunken sailors. Of course, they say they're against big spending, and they're big spenders, but they said they were against big spending because these guys were spending too much, and so then these guys got in and said, we've got to stop spending so much, but they're actually bigger spenders than these guys, and these were enormous spenders. That's weird. These guys are for the war, but they didn't really want to fight it with everything we got. These guys are against war, and they're fighting it exactly the way we've been fighting it. These guys are against corruption. These guys are against corruption. Too bad both of them are corrupt. And then, of course, they're against government health care. Talk to me about prescription drugs. And these guys are for government health care, and they've made our wish come true. Isn't that great? See, here's the thing. This is your choice. The lesser of two evils, progressive L, or the progressive extra strength. That's what it is. And that's by design. I told you a few weeks back about this hep cat, Joel Rogers, dude. You read him, and you think, this guy's a genius. He is. He's one of these big, evil, powerful progressives, you know, who several of those bogus front organization progressives, you know, they used to funnel money around. This guy. This guy started something called the New Party, co-founded the New Party. It's a radical leftist party. In fact, it was the one that supported Barack Obama in Chicago. But that's behind this. Those aren't the facts you're looking for. He said this, the Democratic Party has an abusive relationship with progressives. Democrats take our time and our money, and then they almost always move to the right. The best way to end an abusive relationship is to develop the ability to leave it. We need a meaningful threat of exit from the Democratic Party, a new party that can punish unaccountable Democrats by running against them. That's genius. That's almost like, I remember, the Tea Party. That's the same philosophy. And what did they do? They went and they muscled these people. These people are over. If you think the Democrats still exist, you're fooling yourself. I want you to read what this man said back in the 90s. Read the whole article on this guy and what he said. You can do it at glennbeck.com or sign up for my free email newsletter. It'll be included in there. Grab it right now, will you? Read it. Especially if you're a Democrat. It's done. That was the plan from the beginning. They didn't want to start a new party. They wanted to have legitimate threats so the Democrats would actually listen to them, cave to them. They'd get inside and co-opt them. Now the Democrats are dead. But just as progressives always do, they're not progressives. They're Democrats. They're not progressives. They're liberals. Until they destroy it, and then they become something else. They just used fear and intimidation. Where have I heard that before? Used fear and intimidation. And they co-opted this party. Well, guess what? Democrats, you're done. You're done. You've sold your soul piece by piece, time and time again, to these people. And now it's over. The Democrats that we all knew, most people don't really understand this yet, it's over. It's a progressive party. The Republicans are playing, and they're traveling down the same path, except they're like doing it like Grandpa. They're just moving a little slower. You know what I'm saying? They're just pointing to each other. And we're like, yeah, I hate those guys. Yeah, I hate those guys. That doesn't get us anywhere. He's right. The Republicans have done it. And that's the problem. You see, we've been tricked into boxing ourselves into the R and D and defending those sides at all costs without engaging our brain. All the while, they have morphed into the exact same thing, except extra strength and light. You think you have a distinct choice, but it's really one in the same. There used to be an option in this country. There used to be an option that believed in small government, an option that actually listened to what you had to say. They actually even cared about what you had to say as well. Last night I showed you how progressives think they are better than you. They know more than you. But that's not a problem just exclusive to the left. That is Republicans as well. Lindsey Graham getting hammered by the Tea Partiers for his left-leaning tendencies. Good, keep it up, Tea Partiers. They say they'll vote him out. Well, Lindsey didn't like that, so here's what his statement was from a staff member. Senator Graham is a thinking person's conservative. I expect him to do well among the voters who have IQs in triple digits. Let me go back to Missouri now. Last night, they had a vote on the insurance mandate in Barack Obama's health care bill. It was close, very close, 71 to 29%. Yeah, 71% against it. Now, do you think that's going to stop the administration from going forward? No, of course not. No. Those are just racists, most likely, that voted against it. Or some sort of AstroTurf campaign. You see, you've been ignored all the way, the whole time. 59% want to repeal the health care bill. See, maybe you're confused. You thought this whole country thing was about you and we the people. It's not. No, it's not. It's about them. There's another poll came out from Rasmussen. You have to see this. 84% say the country is headed in the wrong direction. 84%. But over here, this is really interesting. On the right track, 67%. But who are these people? They are the ruling class. These are the people in Washington that are the ruling class. They're the people that know better than you. They have higher IQs than these 84% of peons. So how far apart are we? 151 points. 151 points. That's quite a chasm here. That's not a republic. Shouldn't it be a little closer? Politicians are going in one direction. We're going in another. And when you have it, why did I say on 9/11 it was important for you to know you're not alone? Because if you know you're not alone, you're not going to budge. 84% of Americans know they're not alone. They ain't budging. But almost 70% of those ruling us also don't think they're alone. 70, they're like, look around, these people are stupid out there. Let them eat cake. Hey, that's where I recognize this, the French Revolution. That's right, all we have to do is put little gates here. And we've got Versailles. Isn't that great? These are the people that look at you in their coach. Oh, yes, let them eat cake. How do they live like those peasants? Look, how do you solve this? First of all, you have to get active. You have to read. You have to be informed. You have to pay attention. You're already doing that. Next thing, you vote them out. The next thing, you realize you cannot spend 34 years in Congress and not become arrogant. It is impossible. Our founders knew it. You cannot abide by the law when you're above the law. Two words solves this. Term limits. Both of them say they're for it, all Republicans and Democrats, but they're not. Why? Because they both lose. Term limits. Term limits. If you don't do it, you think these people are going to give up power? They're behind the gates. And you? Who wins? Who wins in this scenario? Well, who's getting the extra power? Are you getting extra power? Or are they gathering power? Who knows what's in these 2,500-page bills? Would that be you or them? Who's writing them? Who even knows how they all connect? Who's exempt from the laws that are in those bills? You or them? Who gets stuck with the tax bill to do those things? You or them? Who has to pay for it when the inevitable happens and it doesn't work and they need even more power, more government, more money? That would be both parties. Both parties are heading the same direction. One's in a jet fighter and the other one's in a horse and buggy, but the destination is the same. Make no mistake. Big spending, arrogance, and corruption.